Something must be done.
You say either, I say either. You say neither, and I say neither. Either, either, and either, neither. Let's call the whole thing off. Yes, you like potato, and I like potato. You like tomato, I like tomato. Potato, potato, tomato, tomato. Let's call the whole thing off. Yeah.
You say laughter and I say laughter. You say after and I say after. Laughter, laughter, after, after. Let's call the whole thing off. You like vanilla and I like vanilla. You sarsaparilla and I sarsaparilla. Vanilla, vanilla, or chocolate, strawberry. Let's call the whole thing off. But oh.
Hey guys, welcome to The Sims 4, a mod tutorial for dummies. If you have not seen any of our other tutorials, please click on the links above to take you to our playlist where you can watch our other tutorials. For our third tutorial, Tomato Tomato, changing text strings, we're going to see how we can change the text within the game so that way we can have it more or less speak to us in a language that we would normally speak. For instance, your text might say, invite somebody to your crib instead of invite somebody to your house. By changing these text strings in the game, it's going to make this game a lot more exciting and fun to play. So with that being said, let's go change some text strings and put this game into more of our language so we can enjoy and have more fun with it. Okay guys, we have a lot to cover in this tutorial, but I first like to start out by saying when I'm putting these tutorials together, I wanted to come up with a concept, or maybe call it a journey, that would take us through each tutorial and have us end at a final destination. The idea that I have come up with is creating a radio station. I thought this was a great idea that can take us through each step of learning different things about The Sims 4 and how to mod in The Sims 4, such as in this tutorial, changing text strings, recoloring clothes, customizing files, creating a sim for a radio station, building a radio station, and changing objects and stuff that fit in with the radio station. Now, the radio station I've chose was WDHA 105.5, The Rock of New Jersey. This is a station that I grew up listening to when I lived in New Jersey. Now, you guys can choose any radio station you like. It doesn't have to be WDHA, it could be any station. The idea is just that hopefully you guys follow me through each one of these tutorials, and we get to the end and we have a radio station built. For today's tutorial, we're going to learn about changing the text strings for this radio station. Now, the funny thing about The Sims 4 is that text is pretty much about 80% of the game, maybe even more. I mean, I'm kind of just making that number up, but it's a lot. I mean, we do everything with text. And one of the funny things is I'll see people spend countless hours trying to create a sim for their game that either looks just like them or like a celebrity, but not take a lot of time in changing the text or the verbiage within the game to make it feel more, you know, realistic, I guess, in a sense. And trust me, I'm to blame at this too. I mean, I spend hours trying to create sims as well. As you can see, here's a couple of my sims. These are my only two, my first two I've ever done, so don't knock me too much. I thought they came out pretty good. Now, since text takes up pretty much a mass majority of the game, it kind of makes sense for us to actually change this text and edit this text so that the game gives us more of a realistic feel to it. I mean, we see text when we're trying to get a job. We see the text to go use the bathroom. We see text to listen to the radio, to cook food, to read a book, or even maybe just, you know, order a pizza. Everything we see is text, 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 text. And we can change this text all throughout the game, everywhere in the game the text shows up, by just using one simple little file. And if you're anything like me, after changing this text, you'll find yourself changing other things that correlate with the text. Maybe change clothes that go with maybe that pizza delivery guy, or maybe you'll change the pizza box that he carries, and then change the icon menu under the phone when you're ordering pizza, or even change the bubble above their head when they're ordering pizza, or when they're even thinking about pizza. By changing text, you could see will lead you into changing other things. That takes a game that's more dull and drabby and brightens it up to a more realistic feel. For our radio station, as you can see, string text is fairly simple. I mean, all it is changing, words that say one thing to the words you want them to say. With our radio station looking like this, we can now make our radio station look like this. From our radio stations listed as musical genres, now we can have our radio stations listed as the actual radio stations, like 105.5 WDHA or 107.3 Cat Country, which gives us a much different feel of the game and how we play it. Okay, now to edit the string table file, we first have to open up S4PE. Once that's open, go up to where it says File, click on it, go to Open, and my program has now automatically opened it to where the file is located. But if you need to know where that's at, it's under Computer, C Drive, Program Files, Origin Games, The Sims 4, Data, Client. Go down the list till you find your language here. It'll say strings plus the abbreviation of your language here. Mine, of course, is English. We will click on that and we will hit Open. Now S4PE has opened up the file. We'll click on it. And as you can see here, here is all the information as far as text and stuff that comes up in your game for The Sims 4. There's roughly probably 6, 7, 8,000, I don't know what it is, lines of text. There is a lot of it. Now before we move on to editing some of this text, I first want to discuss some of these funny numbers up here that's going on here. So let's discuss what some of this is all about, because it's important when we are dealing with string table files and what some of these numbers mean to us. Also, these numbers mean a lot to us when we're dealing with other programs, files such as changing hair colors or pretty much any program file within The Sims 4. These numbers pertain to. Okay, so now what are these numbers and what do they mean? These numbers are hexadecimal and binary conversion numbers that the game looks up to find to run the certain programs or files within the game. Now hexadecimal numbers are numbers that correlate with either a letter or a symbol or a number or even an action so the game can understand it. Almost like, like binary numbers if you know anything about computers. Now I know this can look very intimidating to you, but don't go all crazy. We pretty much won't be messing too much with hexadecimal numbers. I mean, we do play with it a little bit, and we do change some things around. And also, within data files, to show where text files are, you would change hexadecimal numbers there, so that way it could find those string table files. So the first two we see is tag and type. Tag and type are pretty much just the name of the file. One put into of an abbreviation, that's the tag, and the other one, the type, is put into a hexadecimal code so the computer or the game itself can read it. The next line is our group. A group is pretty much what it says. It's a group. It's a group of data that all goes together. Groups I usually don't change. I don't change numbers. You can change the numbers with groups, but I don't like to change them because then you might end up down the line having collisions with other files. If I'm going to change numbers in the game, I usually will change the instance. Now the instance hexadecimal number, think of more like a personal address for that file. Every file within The Sims 4 has its own personal address. Nobody's personal address is the same of that particular tag or type. Now you can have the same instant number with, say, another type of tag or type file, but no tag or type file can have the same instant number or there will be collisions within the game. Now you can change this number to pretty much whatever you want it to be, as long as it's not being used by another file. Now you should always try to change this instant number to nothing close to what's already there, especially if you're going to be making a lot of different texts or adding texts to things that maybe you're going to be sharing with other people, such as like the pizza shirts and stuff that I have text going with. I share that mod out to other people. The reason why I want this text to be totally different and rearranged is you'll see a lot of people will take this text number and, like, you see the last two digits are 48, and they'll just make it 49, and then they'll make it 50, and then they'll make it 51. Well, if you get so many people doing that, the same packet that have that same instance number, it will cause collisions in the game, and you will end up with errors. By changing this number to your own unique number, you would avoid collisions with other people's packages and files. I'll show you later how to change this number using a program that they have within the S4PE. With all pretty much other files, the instant number can be changed completely, except for usually the 0 and the X in the beginning of the number. But string table text is a little bit different, because the first two digits in the beginning of the number, after the 0X, correlate with the language, or your language, which means these two numbers we always want to keep the same, so that way that our game can read the text. Now, as you can see, here's a list of all the different languages and the text code that goes with those languages. 00 being English, 01 being Chinese, and, you know, French being 07. By changing the first two digits after the 0X tells the game what language that file is. Now, since I downloaded my game in English, my data files will search out for text files with the 00 code in the beginning, looking for only the English 00 code files. Now, if you were somebody that lived in Germany, let's say, you downloaded the German version of The Sims 4, so your game will, or your data files in your game, will always look for text files starting with 08. So pretty much all these two numbers in the beginning do is tell the game which language to load. So now if I type out my text string in English, and then put 07, the French code, in the beginning of that text string, it's not going to change the text to French. The text will still remain English. The only thing that will do is allow somebody from France or who downloaded the French game will be allowed to open it up and they'll see English instead of seeing error messages. You'll see a lot of modders put every language text file in there into their package. Pretty much it's just a duplicate of the same text file. But what they'll do is they'll just change the code in the front so that way somebody in Germany opening up the file doesn't just see a bunch of error numbers. They actually see whatever English words that are written. The only way for something to come up in French, you have to write it in French. If you want it in German, you've got to write it in German and then give it its German code. This code only allows the game to load the game in your particular language. That's it. That's all it does. Now, if you ever see an error come up, yeah, I mean, it doesn't have to be these particular numbers like F908CC44 or something along those lines. All this is saying is that either it cannot find your file, which means that the code in the front is probably put in, like, the wrong code, maybe 02, you know, which is Chinese, it might be put under that instead of 00 English, and you have an English game, or the file doesn't exist or it can't find the file at all because it's just not there. So try to always go into your file, make sure your front codes are matching what your language is, and just check, obviously, to make sure you have the file to begin with. So as you can see, those intimidating numbers at the top of the screen aren't as intimidating as you think they are. Pretty much just labels to tell you, you know, or tell the game itself and the data files to where to find certain files that it needs. Hopefully you got this and you didn't go mad, you know, over all these numbers and letters. Now what we want to do is make it easier for us to sort through all these 7,000-8,000 lines of text to find certain things that we want to change, like, let's say, pizza or something like that, or maybe something to do with the text about hiring maid service or something. To make it easier for us to sort through this text, go up to where it says Edit. Go down here to where it says Open in Text Editor. And now what will happen is it will open up a notepad. Okay, now that we have this file, let's save it so we always have a reference to our text. We'll go to File, Save As, and if you haven't created one, I have already, a New Projects folder. In this folder, I'll keep all my projects that I'm working on and stuff, and, you know, there'll be, like, subcategory folders in here, especially to separate text files and folders and stuff like that. But for right now, we've got our file here that we're going to save for a reference, and we'll call it our game string text file. Okay, now we'll hit save. Okay, now that we have saved our file, we now have a file here that we can actually look through and find certain keywords to text that we may want to change in the game. To do this, we go to edit, we hit find, and we could type in a word like made. Check the direction of where you're going in to find this word. This will be up or it will be down. Obviously, if you're starting at the top of the page, we are searching down. And then we just hit find. As you can see, it's already found one of the, our first word here for made. It says cancel made service. Now what we would do is just continue to find the different areas that say made, copy them onto another notepad. So now here's my notepad text file here, and you can see I've got some of the text for made already put in here. This might be all the text for made, I'm not sure. I can't remember, but now I have all my, I open up a file, I call it made service string, and then I have all the lines of text that have the word made in it or relate to the made service itself. Now one of the things I've noticed here is on this line here says Sims can hire a maid or order pizza by using the hire a service option. Well, I noticed the word pizza, and I've actually already made a text string with pizza. So now what I need to know is, have I already used this text string in my pizza text string? Now the way that I figure this out is I actually have another notepad text file that every time I use a text, let's say this here that says made, once I use it, I will copy from the top all the way down to the bottom and place it into this text notepad folder that just is strictly for text that I've used before. This way, when I need to find out whether I've used a text before or not, since I've kept the line number, I'll just type in the line number, which was 571F, into this, you know, file, and it will return whether that line has been used before. And as we could see in my pizza string text, I did use that line. So now that I know that I've used that line in my Pizza Hut string, I'll now go to that string file or folder and change the made, whatever I want to change it to, within that string folder and not put it with the made service string folder. Now keep in mind, you don't have to have separate string folders for separate projects that you're doing. I mean, I happen to have them. I think it's probably better if you can just keep adding, just have one string table and just keep adding to that string table every time you add different, you know, text into the game that you're changing. I personally change, you know, each string table for each thing that I've changed, which means I, you know, write a new instance for that as well every time I'm changing, you know, and making a new string table. Now, when searching for things within the text string, not always can you just type in radio and find, you know, radio. You might sometimes have to type other things. Like, for instance, with our radio station, I would have to type in alternative because that's originally what the bubble there was called, an alternative or blues or classical, to actually find that line of text string to be able to change it. Now, once you've located the string text line that you want, just highlight it, right click, and copy. I usually take the line number with it, even though it doesn't pertain to anything. You'll notice that later when we're putting the text into its own package. But I'll take it with me because I use it later, as I showed you before, for finding line text that I've already used. So now once you hit it, highlight it, you copy it, you bring it over, and you paste it into another folder, which you can see I labeled this one radio station string, and this is my radio station string folder. Okay, now that I have my radio text string all together with all my text lines here that I want to change, I don't want to change my actual original text file. So actually what I want to do is make a new text file so that way I can add my text to it. Now, when modding in The Sims, we never want to use our original data files in case we delete something or change something we shouldn't have. So what we want to do is always make a copy of whatever file that we're working on and modify that file. This way, if we have changed something we shouldn't have, we can always revert back to our original file. And trust me, I know, I'm human too. When putting together this tutorial, I accidentally erased my string English text file, and it wasn't very easy to try to find another file to replace it. In fact, I had to re-download my game again just so I can get the right English file. Any of the files that I found online didn't have all the updates that my file did, so that's why I had to re-download my game to get that file. Now, if you bought your game at a department store, chances are all those files that you need for your language and probably files for the other languages will be on the disk that came with the game. So for right now, all we want to do is copy this file. And what we're going to do is just simply go onto the file, right click, hit copy. Then open up our new projects folder that we created on our desktop. I actually created another folder here called STBL files. I'm going to open that up. I'm going to right click again and I'm going to hit paste. Now that we have a copy of this file, we can use this to change whatever text we want to change without ruining our original file and breaking our game. Now you can use this copy to make whatever changes you want and just go down the list and then just add it into your mods folder. But in my case, since I make string table text for certain projects that I'm working on, I don't want to send somebody the complete string table in case they have other mods that are in their program that will conflict with those mods that they got from maybe somebody else or they created themselves. Now if I was just doing this for myself, I would probably just sit here and just keep altering whatever text lines I want to change in the game. But for this tutorial, what we're going to do is we're just going to make our own string table file. To do this, first what we want to do is get rid of this copy that we have in here. So we're going to start off brand new by going up, hitting file, and hitting new. Then what I want to do is get my own unique instant number. So I'll come up to here where it says tools, hit this FNV hash, and you'll see a dialog box will pop up here. Now you can write pretty much whatever you want in this text hash area here. I'm going to write my modding handle name, which is Sinister Simmer, and then I just hit calculate. And as you can see, it calculated an 8-bit hexadecimal number, it calculated a 16-bit, and for an instant number, we want a 16-bit, so we're going to highlight this and we're going to copy it. Then we're going to close this down. Okay, so now to make a new package, or in this case, a new string table file, we're going to come up here to where it says resource, click on that, and hit add. Now this detailed dialog box will pop up, and what we're going to want to do is pick the type, and our type obviously is going to be a string table. So click on that, scroll down till we find our abbreviation for it, which is right here. And as you can see, it has the abbreviation plus the hexadecimal code, the type that goes along with it. We're going to click on that. Now we got to add our group. Now, like I said before, I never change the group. I always keep it at 0, and there are 8 digits for the group. And then our instance number, which we just copied, and we'll paste that in here. Now, there's one other thing we need to change with this. I wonder what it could be. That's right. We have to change the first 2 digits to our language. Ours is English, so we'll be changing it to 00. Now everything looks good, so we'll just click OK. And as you can see, we have created a new file. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to save this file, so that way I can use it again instead of going through that process of making another blank file. And when I use it again, all I'll need to do is change the instance number, so that way it's a different instance. So by doing that, I go to File, I go to Save As, and we are going to go right into our new projects file, which is on our desktop. And as you can see, I have made another little folder in here called STBL, and I'm going to double click on that, and then I'm going to save this folder here as, or file I should say, as my blank, and then hit Save. Okay, now I'm all ready to begin to put in my own text into this string table file. Okay, now I brought up my radio station string that's in my notepad, and I'm going to put this text into the string table. Now, one of the ways to do this is to go up to where it says resource, then come down here to where it says edit STBL. And as you can see, a pop-up dialog box comes up. And in here, obviously, it's blank. And here's where we would begin to put in our string text. Now, to do this, it's fairly simple. What I'll do is come over here and copy this 8-bit line code here. I will place it in here, hit paste, and then I'll just hit add. Now, this code number here, or hexadecimal number, is extremely important because this hexadecimal number correlates with a data file that is searching for this number to return what it says here. So we don't ever want to change this number if this is the text that we want to be returned in the game at a particular point. Now, if we were to change this number, and this number, let's say, correlates with something like, you know, let's woo-woo or something, and we were to put our text turned on, well, maybe that would probably work out, but it won't show up in the right spot where we want it to show up. So let's always try to keep this number will always stay the same to whatever text you want to go with that number. Now, to add the text in, we'd have to click here, and there's no paste option here, so if I right click, I can't get a paste option, so that won't work. So I would have to write in what it's telling us here, or what we wrote here, and I would have to write it into this area, and then pretty much it's added already. So you can see if I click over here, it's added to it. But I mean, what if I have a long list of stuff, you know, must have just missed out the point of a, you know, right-click paste option. So it makes it a little more difficult through this editor to, you know, put your text in here. I'm not a speed typer, so for me, it makes it difficult. But lucky enough, there is a way around this. What we'll do is we'll just save this for now. We'll say yes. And pretty much what that did was said that it saved that line on there. And then, of course, it took the blank duplicate and it turned it to delete. So what we'll do is just right now we'll hit save. And if we hit save, it just gets rid of that other file. So now the way around this is instead of going to where the editor is at here, what we're going to do is go down here to where the grid is at. So click on grid, and then this other dialog box will come up. So if we go to the first line here and go all the way to, click on this, then go all the way to the end over here where it's dot, 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 click on that, and then we'll see our key and our value. Our key being our number here for our line text, and our value being what we want it to say. We'll now come down here to the bottom, and you can either add or insert. Insert will put it in the front of what we have here, and add will put it after it. So we'll just hit add. Now we'll come over here and we will copy our code number. We'll place it in where the key value is. I guess there's another thing you can call it. You can call it your key value. Alright. And then we'll do the same thing for the text line that we want to put in there. We'll hit it, copy. And as you can see, if I come over here and I hit paste, it will allow me finally to paste. So this way, if I have a lot of, like a long line of text, I'm not sitting there retyping out the whole text that I've already typed out in my notepad. And then after that, we will hit OK. We will hit commit. And as you can see, that new line of text is now put into our string table file. Now that we have all our put into our string table file, we can now save our string table file. One of the things I wanted to point out was is you could see how the line numbers, don't really have to worry about these line numbers as they'll place these line numbers in. They're pretty much reference numbers for the game, I guess. It doesn't really matter if this line is here or this line is here or where it is. I think they're just pretty much reference numbers for the game. Like I said before, the original line numbers I just use as my reference for looking up text that I have already used. Now what I'll do is I'll save this file. I'll click File. I'll hit Save As. And we want to go back to my desktop, to my Projects folder. And we will save this as our radio station. And then we will click Save. And then after we're done saving it, we can close down our S4PE and place the folder into our mods folder. Okay, now that we have placed our radio station package into our mods folder, we can now go into the game and see what our radio stations look like. But before we go into our game, there's one other thing I want to show you that would deal with our radio stations. And if we go under our EA Electronics, The Sims 4, under our documents, where the mods folder is held, there's another folder here called Custom Music. And in this folder, if we open it up, is all of the genres or music for the radio station. Now, within these folders is where you would place MP3 files of your songs and music that you would want played on the Sims radio. Now, you can change the names of these files. I have not done it yet. I eventually will. But you could change the names of these, and these do not alter or change anything within the game of the files that are in the game for these particular genres of radio stations. Now, if we go under, let's say, our classical file, you could see all the music that I have already installed into my game. So you can see this is a very simple thing to do. Most music already is in an MP3 format, so all you really pretty much have to do is pick it up and drop it in. Okay, now in the Sims 4 game, I'll show you where those files are located. Go under the three dots up here, then click on Game Options, and then click on Music. And as you can see, here's the list of all of our radio stations. And those files that are in our documents under Electronic Arts, where our mods folder is, as you can see, these ain't the names of the folders that are under our documents Electronic Arts folder. These are the names of the actual radio stations that we have created. Okay, guys, so in this tutorial, you've learned about tag, type, group numbers, instant hexadecimal numbers. You've also learned how to edit your text files, where to find them, and how to edit them through S4PE. You've also learned where the files are located to add your own music into the game. So I think you're ready to start writing some new text strings. So in the next tutorial coming up, the tutorials I promise will start getting a little bit shorter as I don't have to go over the same information I went over in this tutorial. So until our next tutorial, happy modding.